It started as an idea in the mid-1970s in Lakeland, Florida, to preserve and enhance the future of flight, inspiring and educating people of all ages. The first fly-in attracted 365 planes, and the candle was lit. Over the next four decades, oh, how it has grown. Today, the Sun and Fun International Fly-In and Expo is the second largest aviation event of its kind in the world. A place to celebrate the incredible panorama of aviation. A place where tradition meets innovation. A place where songs are sung by sounds. A place unlike any other. This is the 2018 Sun and Fun International Fly-In and Expo.
Guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Lift off.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Larry Strain.
And I'm Rob Ryder.
And welcome to Sun and Fun 2018. We're the three narrators up here that are going to be describing all of the activity that you're going to see today, not only here, but worldwide, throughout the world, because we are on live TV, on the internet. It's airshowlivetv.com. So go there, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to watch it from your home, because it's going to be really exciting. We have a few housekeeping items to go before we start our show, particularly for those folks right here that are actually watching the show from the grounds, and that is no smoking at any time. The airplanes here are loaded with fuel. We don't want any accidents. So, ladies and gentlemen, there are a few designated areas for smoking. We urge you to go there. And if you see somebody with a lighted cigarette or pipe or cigar, kindly ask them to put it out. We don't want any accidents. Secondly, leather up with sunscreen, because we've got a nice cool breeze blowing and you may feel comfortable, but don't go home with a sunburn, and particularly lather up with the young kids. In addition to that, stay hydrated. Drink plenty of liquids today, because the biggest problem we have at air shows, and I think, Rob, you'll agree with this, is dehydration.
Yeah, we don't want people dropping off in the middle of the show and missing some of this incredible lineup that you've been told about already.
And the biggest thing that we have in regards to injuries are trips and falls. So look where you are going at all times, please.
Don't be a digital dead walker, right?
Exactly. All right, we've asked everybody to relax and take their seats here for the air show. For you folks at home, we'd like for you to relax too. We'd like for you to relax and sit back in your couch or your comfortable armchair. And if it's time over there for a brew, whether you are in France or Australia or New Zealand or perhaps Italy, relax and enjoy the show on Live Air Show TV. And we would love to have your comments on Facebook or any of the social media, so please, yeah. All right, now we're just about ready to start, but before we go to the national anthem, here is a great story and a great song by Mr. Johnny Cash.
Through a county courthouse square, on a park bench, an old man was sitting there. I said, "Your old courthouse is kind of run down." He said, "No, it'll do for our little town." I said, "Your old flagpole is leaned a little bit, and that's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it." He said, "Have a seat," and I sat down. "Is this the first time you've been to our little town?" I said, I think it is. He said, I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little hole in that flag there when Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key said, watching it right and say, can you see? And it got a bad rip in New Orleans, Pakenham and Jackson tugging at it seems. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on though. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville, and she got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she got a big hole from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low a time or two. She was in Korea, Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved from our ships upon the briny foam, and now they've about quit waving back here at home. In her own good land here, she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, and refused. And the government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. And she's getting threadbare and she's wearing thin, but she's in good shape for the shape she's in. She's been through the fire before, and I believe she can take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning. We take her down every night. We don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her up right. On second thought, I do like to brag, because I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag.
Great story and a great song, like I said, by Johnny Cash. And now with a special guest here at the beginning of our 2018 Sun and Fun, here's the man that makes it all work together, the director of operations for Sun and Fun, Mr. Greg Gibson.
Thank you, Larry Strain. Everyone, welcome to Sun and Fun 2018. My name's Greg Gibson. I am the director of air operations here at Sun and Fun. And I just can't tell you how thrilled we are to have everyone watching live on Live Air Show TV here. Sun and Fun is really proud to announce that this year we are the inaugural event of the Grunt Style Air Show Majors. It's the first series of its kind, and we're very pleased to join Houston, Jones Beach, New York, and Cleveland in the Grunt Style Air Show Majors. Special thanks to Red Frog Events for putting that together. And of course, here locally, we are sponsored, our presenting sponsor is Visit Florida. And I'm here with Brandy Hastings, who is a representative of Visit Florida. And Brandy, tell us a little bit about Visit Florida's mission and what you guys do for the state of Florida and tourism.
We're the Tourism Marketing Corporation for the state of Florida. We tell people how awesome Florida is and invite them to come here. And thank you all that did get to come and visit and come to Sun and Fun. If you're not here, if you're streaming live, go to visitflorida.com and start planning your trip.
I think you've done that before. That sounded really good. Well, Sun and Fun, of course, we've got a phenomenal event lined up for you here. Some of the world's greatest aviators, certainly have the world's greatest announcing staff right here. And I want to thank Larry Strain, Rob Ryder, Dave Keim, Jay Rabbit in the sound booth back here for doing all he's doing. And, of course, our friends at Live Air Show TV for bringing this to you live around the world. Make sure you check us out on Facebook and Twitter. We always have the hashtags of LoveFL. SNF18 to make sure you're tagging all of this. Share and share away. There's all kind of promotions and things that you'll see coming along in order to participate in and start those conversations. So, Larry, we've got a couple of pretty exciting acts lined up here. Who's leading us off today?
Well, we're going to lead off with the Paracommandos bringing in the United States flag and singing the national anthem. They'll be along in about 2 minutes from now, Greg. And then we're going just charging, and we've got some of the best performers in the world flying right here at Sun and Fun 2018.
You bet. I know also we have coming up something really unique. We have the United States Air Force Heritage Flight that'll be participating with us today. And right behind that, something super rare to see at air shows is a Navy Legacy flight to go along with that. And we're very excited. We certainly appreciate John Rainwaters for coming in with the F-16 demo. We appreciate Chins for coming in with the F-18 Super Hornet. Of course, Jim Tobel and the Corsair joining him. Then we have the Lewis Air Legends and their P-38. Kavanaugh Flight Museum is also following along with their P-40, respectively piloted by Steve Hinton and Stuart Milton.
Yes, that's great. And for the folks that don't know what the Heritage Flight is, it's the old and the new, the past and the present. Been going on for 20 years now. It's the heritage of the United States Air Force as well as the United States Navy. Greg, thank you for coming up, and thank you.
Larry, thank you, Brandon. Appreciate it very much.
Thank you so much. Let's have a great day at Sun and Fun.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, high above us right now is the helicopter on board. Paracommandos from Special Ops Command. Matthew Word, a freshman at Harrison School of Arts, is going to sing our national anthem. He recently performed in Harrison's When You Dream musical about Publix founder George Jenkins. He enjoys singing and performing and has always been involved in many productions at Lakeland Community Theater. Matthew also participates on Lakeland High School's baseball team. In his free time, he also enjoys playing golf and tennis. Now, high above you, there is the helicopter. Mr. Jeff Shetterly in the T-6 will be circling our jumper today, who is Master Sergeant Jeff Duncan. And then once he is on the ground, Lieutenant Colonel Aaron Carl will take over to tell you about the Paracommandos and the Special Operations Command. Watch now as you will see Master Sergeant Duncan leave the helicopter. He's out and it falling, and immediately deploys that Paracommandos parachute. Jeff Shetterly will follow him down to 2,500 feet as he circles around our jumper with his smoke on. And at that time, ladies and gentlemen, we will call on you to stand for our national anthem to be sung once again by Matthew Word. Flag has been deployed. That's 1,500 square feet of a United States flag up there floating so gently towards the grounds here at Sun and Fun. Nice smooth air for the Paracommandos today. Like I said, once he is on the ground, then you'll be treated to a second pass by the Paracommandos, and they will be doing some amazing parachuting for you.
This is a traditional air show opening for us. And as we see this, Larry, having somebody circle the jumper, it's just one of those things that's worth one of those Nikon moments.
Yes, grab your Nikon camera, get ready, because you're going to need it all afternoon long, ladies and gentlemen. We've got lots of sponsors. Jeff Shetterly, who is circling the jumper, will immediately go into his routine after we have the second pass by the Paracommandos. He'll be doing it in about six minutes. All right, ladies and gentlemen, please rise, remove your cover for the singing of our national anthem.
By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleam, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we'd watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave land of the free and the home of the brave.
Wow. Stirring rendition of our national anthem, expertly timed, ladies and gentlemen, by Matthew Word, a freshman at Harrison School of Arts. Right now, ladies and gentlemen, Lieutenant Colonel Aaron Carl is here to tell you more about the Para Commandos.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Lieutenant Colonel Aaron Carl, United States Air Force, today representing United States Special Operations Command. Can I start off by getting another round of applause, please, for United States Marine Corps Master Sergeant Jeff Duncan with that amazing pass with the U.S. flag, perfectly timed with that beautiful rendition of the national anthem. Thank you so much. We also want to give a shout out to the Florida Wing of the Civil Air Patrol, who was our cadet flag detail, making sure that that flag was treated with great respect at all times. Thank you so much. All right, ladies and gentlemen, high above you, my team is on their second pass, and we do have jumpers away. You'll notice the pink smoke, which allows you to see them on their way in. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we are the U.S. SOCOM Paracommandos, the Command Parachute Team. SOCOM is located in beautiful Tampa, Florida at MacDill Air Force Base and is the Joint Combatant Command that oversees all U.S. military special operations, including U.S. Army Green Berets and Army Rangers, the U.S. Navy SEALs, U.S. Air Force, Pararescue and Combat Controllers, and the U.S. Marine Corps Raiders, as well as a myriad of other special operations and special operations support activities. It's important to know that on any given day, there are more than 70,000 soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, and DoD civilians in more than 70 countries around the world doing the great work of the U.S. Special Operations Command. Now, it may be awesome to watch our guys in the air do what they do, but a quick shout out to our ground crew today, our drop zone safety officer, U.S. Marine Corps Sergeant Corey McKenzie, making sure we have a safety Z. Thanks, Corey. Ladies and gentlemen, he can hear you. Please make me look good. This is my boss. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause, please, for DoD Parachute Officer Keith Walter, the Big Kahuna. In our stack out formation that we're doing today. This, ladies and gentlemen, is every group has to have one. The class clown, I'm sure you have one in your group too. This is United States Marine Corps Raider Master Sergeant Red Smith. Make sure he can hear you. And in the coveted position, the last position to come in on a stack out, we call that being top of the world. He is also our jump master today. This, ladies and gentlemen, is United States Army Airborne Staff Sergeant Rob Little. Welcome to the party, Rob. Woo-hoo! Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our demonstration for today. If you would like to learn more about Special Operations Command and the Paracommandos, you can check us out at socom.mil or use the Paracommandos as your keyword on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. On behalf of the command and the more than 70,000 special operators around the world, we say thank you for your attention and support. Have a great day. Enjoy sun and fun.
Thanks, Aaron. Very much. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the Paracommandos. And now, entering the air show box and climbing high into this incredible sky above Lakeland is Jeff Shetterly.
He comes from a family of flyers, and today he flies the radial rumble of the North American SNJ. He's brought to you today by Republic Airlines. As a matter of fact, throughout Jeff's career, after going to his United States Military Academy at West Point boot camp and getting commissioned in the Army as an Army officer basic course where he learned to command platoon-sized elements of Abrams tanks, he retired from the Army, returned to the United States, and picked up his aviation career in his flying Shetterly family. In the years since our radial rumble, performer has become an instrument-rated commercial pilot and a certified flight instructor in over 100 aircraft types. But it dawned on him one day that in the history of powered flight, there's never been a better time to pursue a career in aviation as a pilot. So today, Jeff is doing just that with Republic Airlines. Who is Republic Airlines? Well, if you've ever flown on United Express, the Delta Connection, or American Eagle and thought to yourself, wow, this is really comfortable. I can stand up straight and have lots of room for my carry-on. There's a good chance you were riding on the Republic Airlines 175 large modern regional jet. Jeff couldn't be happier with his decision to become an airline pilot with Republic. With 10 bases east of the Rockies, the largest fleet of Embraer 175s on the planet, competitive pay, world-class training, and a solid group of captains to fly with, Republic is the ideal place to begin a career or even a second career as a professional pilot. Now let's watch Jeff as he comes in from the right-hand side. He is flying this SNJ aircraft, not just as a hobby. Watch the precision with which he does each of these maneuvers, stopping at every 90 degrees, very, very crisp in this four-point hesitation roll. That's 5,000 plus pounds of growling, grueling advanced trainer. The type of aircraft that taught tens of thousands of military cadets to fly. It does not have an inverted fuel and oil system. So as he comes back down across show center, he does half of a Cuban 8, rolls it upright, and gets the fuel flow back into the carburetor. Jeff wants to thank Whelan Engineering for their amazing night display lights, Champion Aerospace, Bose Aviation Headsets, the University of Central Missouri Aviation Department Online Trading Academy, PLC Enterprises, and also Concord Battery and B&B Aircraft Supplies. As a matter of fact, Concord Batteries just put a battery in his plane yesterday when it was in need, and he really wanted to make sure that we gave them a great big thank you. The rudder on a T6 is extremely effective and watches it. He uses it to its full potential all the way through this routine. Coming down from the left side. Just a young gun with the quick fuse. I was uptight. Now he goes to the 8-point hesitation roll. Again, every 45 degrees, stopping it very crisply. This is exceptionally hard to do in an airplane that weighs 5,000 pounds. That's 2.5 tons. We're gonna see a demonstration of that rudder effectiveness in just a couple of seconds. I have been told that the most difficult maneuver to do well is a super slow roll with the coordination that it takes between aileron and rudder and power to make a straight line across the show line. Let's watch as Jeff now does his super slow roll in this T6. The SNJ, the Texan, North American's advanced trainer, and you can see those wheeling lights going now with two slow rolls across the line. Ladies and gentlemen, representing Republic Airlines, let's hear it for Jeff, Radio Rumble Shetterly.
Don't
If you're interested in pursuing a career in aviation, you can seek out Jeff. That's a 5G pull right there. Seek out Jeff to talk about your options, and you can catch him after this performance in the autograph booth, which is just to the right of show center in the first of the tents right at the beginning of the Warbird area, and you can talk to him about the folks at Republic Airlines or connect at the Republic Airlines tent. Way at the right-hand side of the aerobatic box. He's going up and over the top. He throws that stick over to the left. And comes in for his next pass. And he holds it there in knife-edge flight. Propeller tips going supersonic at about 2,250 RPM. How about a huge, huge round of applause once again for a magnificently performed knife edge pass. He's been cleared to land. We've got lots more for you. And I want to say thanks to the folks at Sporty's Pilot Shop and Hartsville Propeller for bringing me here this week. Now back to the voice of Lucas Oil. Here's Larry Strain.
Thank you very much, Rob. Sun and Fun thanks our sponsor, Alpina Watches. Since 1883, Alpina is the original sports watch worn by mountain climbers, divers, and pilots. For the second year, Alpina Watches is proud to be the official Sun and Fun timekeeper and to have Michael Goulian as its brand ambassador. Michael is well known for his athletic and aggressive precision flying, decades of airshow performances, and Red Bull races. Coming up next, an unusual airplane. It's a Bonanza, and you say, wait a minute, I thought a Bonanza was just a small airplane used, by folks that just wanted to go A to B in that. Well, wait, and here to tell you all about it is a good friend of mine, Mr. Brian Norris.
Thanks so much, Larry. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Brian Norris, diving into the aerobatic box, coming to you from Pierce, South Dakota, where the Midwest meets the Wild West. I'd like to introduce to you Mr. Jim Pites and his aerobatic bonanza. Jim is a South Dakota native, and he is totally immersed in aviation. He is the owner of Mustang Aviation, which is a full-service FBO located in his hometown of Pierce, South Dakota, that includes charter, air freight, flight instruction, maintenance, and aircraft sales. At Air Show Center, watch closely now as Jim takes that aerobatic bonanza to the vertical, a quarter roll on the way up, and he is going to pull it over the top for the descending down line. Jim is happiest when he is in the air and heavily promotes aviation everywhere that he goes. Coming out of the half Cuban 8, turn around back to Air Show Center. Watch as Jim starts approximately 10 feet above the ground for the inside loop. And also watch closely on the Jumbotron because they do have live cameras mounted in the aircraft while Jim is performing for you here this afternoon. Since his first solo flight 43 years ago, Jim has amassed more than 15,000 hours of accident-free flight time in more than 147 different models of aircraft. Now in the Hammerhead turnaround down at Far Air Show Right, Jim is going to bring this beautiful aircraft back to Air Show Center. This aircraft that you see Jim flying is not your ordinary Bonanza, obviously. This is a 1986 F-33C Bonanza. The C denotes that is the aerobatic version of this aircraft. This aircraft is, in fact, fully certified for aerobatics, and it is one of only 118 of its type ever produced, and it is actually one of the very last F-33Cs to run off of the production line. As Jim comes out of the wing over and back to show center, watch for the 8-point roll. There's 4 points, 5, 6, 7, and 8 points of the 8-point roll. While watching Jim do his performance, keep in mind that this aircraft is not equipped with an aerobatic system. It does not have inverted fuel, and it does not have an inverted oil system. Out of the turnaround, back at Air Show Center, the nose comes up for the 4-point roll. This year marks Jim's 26th year of performing aerobatics, and over the years, he has entertained millions of spectators all throughout North America doing air shows in the United States and Canada. Rolling out of the half, Cuban 8, and driving back down to air show right, Jim is going to set up for another hammerhead turnaround. The F-33C that you see Jim flying is actually certified for positive 6 all the way down to negative 3 Gs. Obviously, Jim is a highly experienced aerobatic pilot, and this is definitely not your stock Bonanza, so he wanted me to point out to all of the Bonanza owners in the audience, please do not try this at home. Jim is probably best known for his high G gyroscopic show that he used to do in an Extra 300L. With the Bonanza, he is most amazed that the responses that he gets with this Bonanza, because people are just not used to seeing a four-place family aircraft flying inverted, vertical uplines, and doing snap rolls. This aircraft is equipped with a stock Continental IO 550 engine, and it is turning a three-bladed Hartzell Super Scimitar propeller. And for avionics, Jim has the latest glass panel technology from Aspen. Jim is then going to turn this aircraft around and return for his photo pass. So, ladies and gentlemen, get your cameras ready. Jim has served for 6 years on the board of directors of the International Council of Air Shows, with 2 of those years being spent as its chairman. And also in 2014, he won the highest honor that can be given in the air show industry. That is the ICAS Sword of Excellence. And now, lo and from the right, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jim Pites and the F-33 Aerobatic Bonanza. And as Jim sets up for landing, we'd like to thank our good friends at Sirius XM Aviation. Dan Dickerson, I believe, is down at Air Show Center. Aspen Avionics, Phillips 66, Whalen Engineering, Kelly Manufacturing, Oregon Aero, and of course, Jim's own FBO, Mustang Aviation in Pierce, South Dakota. Now back to my good friend, Mr. Larry Strain.
Thank you so much, Brian Norris. And Rob, Dave Keim, and I will be right back after this.
How beautiful, for heroes proved in the self their country loved, and mercy more than life.
There's Mr. Jim Pites taxing in with his bonanza. We'll be ready to go here in just a moment. I want to remind you folks that after each performer performs, they'll be driven by in this convertible that you see coming here off to your right. As they get in front of you, please wave and give them a nice round of applause for flying today.
I sure as heck want to thank our good buddy, all the good buddies at Sporty's Pilot Shop. And since the Young Eagles program started in 1992, over 2 million people have received introductory flights. And 50,000 of those kids received at no charge the complete Sporty's Private Pilot video course, a $200 value. That's a $10 million investment in the future of aviation. Thank you, Sporty's Pilot Shops.
The name Franklin has been associated with mind-blowing, heart-pounding air show performances for more than 50 years. In 1992, Kitbox Aircraft teamed up with Franklin's Flying Circus to debut their Kitbox Model 4. Flown by legendary air show pilot Jimmy Franklin, the Model 4 wowed the crowds at EAA Air Ventures, and then again the following season right here at Sun and Fun. Last year, for the 50th anniversary of Franklin's Flying Circus and the 25th anniversary of Kitbox Aircraft, Kitbox and Franklin's Flying Circus teamed up once again. This time, Jimmy's son Kyle, an amazing performer in his own right, and the winner of the 2017 Bill Barber Award for Showmanship, would be putting the S7 Speedster through its paces and wowing the crowds at AirVenture once again. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure to draw your attention to the skies above Lakeland as Kitbox Aircraft proudly presents Kyle Franklin and the S7 Speedster. Watch now as Kyle Franklin tumbles the S7 Speedster down into the aerobatic box. Way up high in the skies over Lakeland. Snapping it over at the top for an avalanche loop. The Kitbox was first introduced in 1984, and since then has continued to be a leader in sport aviation, delivering easy-to-build kits, hours of flying fun, and an impeccable safety record, all at a price the average person can't afford. Here he comes, all about energy management in the Kitbox. He brings it way up high in the sky, flipping it over on its back, hanging on the harness. Now he's gonna bring all that airspeed right back down to show center. The original Model 4 Speedster was powered by a Rotax 912 under a radial round cowling that is classic Kitbox. The new Series 7 Speedster is powered by a fuel-injected Rotax 912IS under a sleek, smooth cowling. Out in front is an Airmaster constant speed propeller. It's larger, capable of carrying more baggage and higher gross weights. Look at Kyle Franklin bring it down to the ground. Way up over, hanging on the harness one more time, turning it over for you, Lakeland. Hard and fast, right back down to Air Show Center. Up, over the top, flipping it over on the 45-degree down line to complete the Cuban 8. The kit box is equipped with a Garmin flight display, and it's all lit up with Aero LED lights. It has a top speed of 140 miles per hour in level flight, and folks, he's doing that on 100 horsepower. Looky there. I'm pretty sure he almost touched the wheels on that one. Beautiful Over and Over by Kyle Franklin. The Speedster shines thanks to the brilliant green and black PPG finish and a dream scheme design. The S7 features a folding wing design for easy storage and trailering. That's right, you can get this plane. The wings will fold up, it'll fit inside your trailer, and you can haul it from show to show. Look at Kyle Franklin bringing it low and fast down onto the ground. It has a range of 612 nautical miles, and it's rated for 5.7 Gs. The entire show you're seeing here today is all done in positive G maneuver. This will give you a good look at that dream scheme design on the bottom of the kit box as it comes by this time. Here he comes, right down the show line, and then up and over the top one more time. Beautiful aileron roll in the Kitfox S7 Speedster. The Kitfox doesn't actually have ailerons, it actually has flaperons. Doubles both flap and ailerons for the Kitfox. Ladies and gentlemen, here he comes with a knife-edge climb in the Kitfox S7 Speedster. Here it comes, low and fast, one more time. Get your cameras out. Get a shot of the beautiful S7 Speedster as Kyle Franklin handles it right down the show line. Kyle would like to take the opportunity to thank a few of his sponsors. Garmin Dream Scheme Design, EarthX Batteries, AirMaster Propellers, Aero LED, PPG Aerospace. To learn more, visit Kitfox Aircraft. You can find them on Instagram, Facebook, or by visiting their website at www.kitfoxaircraft.com. Also, be sure to check out franklinairshows.com. Ladies and gentlemen, for Kitfox Aircraft, Franklin's Flying Circus, I'm Alan Mitchell. Thank you, and enjoy the rest of Sun and Fun 2018.
Thank you, Alan. Touching down, there's Kyle. Nice job. Lots more to come, Larry Strain. We are on a roll.
Absolutely, and we'll be right back. We want you to watch this at home if you're there or on the Jumbotrons here.
Please, please, oh! No! 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 The running of the bold dogs? Surprising. What's not surprising? How much money Aaliyah saved by switching to Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
And we are back with lots more to come here at Sun and Fun 2018. My name is Rob Ryder. With me, Larry Strain and also Dave Keim. And just wanted to say, since 1917, 101 years ago, the Hartzell Propeller Company started making propellers for the Wright Brothers early aircraft. And now, 101 years later, still spinning with the most advanced propellers on the most advanced aircraft in the world, including the entire Cirrus SR fleet. Thank you to Hartzell Propeller helping bring me here today. And now the voice of Lucas Oil, your sponsor, back to Larry Strain.
Thank you, Rob. On the takeoff roll, knife edge climb out. Ladies and gentlemen, that's Miss Hattie Wagstaff. One of aviation's most accomplished pilots you're seeing right now, ladies and gentlemen, Patty Wagstaff. Patty's considered one of the most skilled and exciting pilots on the airshow circuit today. She is a three-time U.S. National Aerobatic Champion, a six-time member of the U.S. Aerobatic Team competing in Olympic-level international competition, and a six-time winner of the Betty Skelton First Lady of Aerobatics Award. Her airplane, the Extra 260 that she flew to become the first woman to win the U.S. Nationals, is now on display at the Smithsonian's National Air and Space Museum on the Mall in Washington, D.C. Patty has won many awards for her flying, and in 2004, she was inducted into the National Aviation Hall of Fame. She's received the National Air and Space Museum for current achievement and was honored by the U.S. Air Force with their Lifetime Achievement Award. Today, Patty's flying the Extra 330 SC, the state-of-the-art single-seat Extra built in Germany. Built for world-level aerobatics by Walter Extra in Germany, the 330 SC Sports has a Lycoming Thunderbolt engine and MT propeller and is imported into the U.S. by Southeast Aero Services in St. Augustine, Florida, the U.S. dealer for the Extra aircraft. Patty is also proud to be an ambassador for AOPA, the Aircraft Owners and Pilots Association, protecting our right to fly over 75 years. Just watch Patty fly, ladies and gentlemen, precision and perfection in her maneuvers. Patty pushes a lot of negative or outside G's. She pulls 10 G's, pushes negative or outside at 7 G's during her routine. Notice the knife edge climb and a three-quarter snap to that as she took off. And she'll be doing a ribbon cut for you just a little bit later on. And then as she closes her show, one of the most difficult maneuvers that a pilot can accomplish, and that is a 360-degree circle. Actually, it's going to be 270 with Patty. Circling one way and rolling the aircraft the other way. It is very, very complex, and it takes a special kind of pilot to do that. Extra 330 from St. Augustine. That's where Patty lives, up in St. Augustine, Florida. Runs a flight school up there. While not performing, she operates an aerobatic school. Patty Wagstaff Aviation Safety, offering aerobatic and upset training in two locations, right there in St. Augustine, also in Orlando at the Kissimmee Airport. It focuses on airmanship, aerobatics, and upset training for the student to professional pilot. And Patty Wagstaff Aviation Safety recently partnered with Simcom, who offers business and general aviation pilots the best quality simulator training at the best prices in the industry. Patty is also doing corporate upset training, which I will be doing the ground school portion for her as she develops that. This is precision flying at its best, ladies and gentlemen. So crisp, so beautiful to watch. Watch the control movements, how quick that airplane is to respond. Like I said, it was built in Germany. Walter Extra designed the first airplanes of his genre, if you will, and it, for one reason only, and that was to compete in international aerobatic competition. And they have grown from the first models to several models. Now Patty flies the 330 SC, the single seat in the inverted, and look how close she flies to the runway with that tail. Right to the knife edge and a slider across the sky. Now you can see the folks. Patty sets up now for that maneuver. I believe she's going to close out with, yep. Very difficult. Turning the airplane in a 360-degree circle to the right while rolling the airplane to the left. Very, very incredible. Cutting that ribbon right to the vertical. Rudder yawing the airplane around and without the use of any ailerons, just to slide it and skid it across the sky, if you will. Miss Patty Wagstaff. Patty practices almost every day, as do most of these performers. Very physically demanding on the G-loads. Like I said, Patty pulls up 6 to 7 Gs. And what we mean by G-forces, you and I are generating 1 G as we stand here on the ground. If you are pulling 6 Gs in a maneuver, that's the force of gravity pushing you down in the seat 6 times your own weight. And it's just the opposite for negative Gs. Blood rushing to the head. Eyeballs can get very, very hurt. Patty in there is what you call about a 5G pull. Doesn't bother Patty. All of the performers as they practice look at that snap roll from vertical right to vertical. Beautifully done, and the hammerhead turnaround. British called it a stall turn. Climb to the vertical, let the airplane run out of airspeed, little right aileron to counteract the torque, and then stand on that left rudder, let it rotate around its own axis. The hammerhead turnaround.
Boy, she really stays on the G's in that half Cuban, doesn't she?
She does indeed. And this is not something that you can just go out and do. You got to build up the G loads. All right. Torque roll. No more airspeed. Lets it back right down and the tail slide. And then the nose comes through the horizon. And Patty points the aircraft directly to show center. You know, we're broadcasting worldwide on Live Air Show TV. I just had a note from a friend of mine that says, hey, everything is looking great from Sun and Fun. Phil Morrow down in Fort Lauderdale are saying, last pass here, a little photo pass. Let's wave as Patty Wagstaff waves to you with the tail of the airplane. Thank you, Patty. Nice job and very well done. Rob Ryder, Dave Kyle, and I are going to be right back in just a couple of seconds, but we're going to take a quick break here, ladies and gentlemen.
Of M08.com, and this year we're giving away my book, The Private Pilot Blueprint. It's everything I wish someone would have told me before I started my flight training. Come by our booth in Hangar D, Hangar Delta, booth 92, to get your free copy of The Private Pilot Blueprint. Listen, enjoy the rest of Sun and Fun, and most importantly, remember that a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day. We'll see you.
Yes, indeed, just looking at what's been going on here on our Friday edition of the 2018 Sun and Fun International Expo and Fly-In. And boy, just a quick shout out to my buddies at Flight Outfitters, and they've been keeping us in caps and stuff like that. So thank you, Mark Glassmeyer, and everybody like that.
Those bags are absolutely wonderful. I got a bag over there, went over and bought one, and it is outstanding.
The lift, the thrust, the flight level, the bush bags.
Yep.
I'm traveling with all that stuff now. Thanks, Mark. And we've got the U.S. Navy here coming up with the VFA 106 Super Hornet demo team. And
they would be the Gladiators,
Walker,
right?
And, yeah, the Gladiators. And those guys will be up in just a minute. Again, let me ask a question. What of Michael Goulian, Sean D. Tucker, John Klatt, and every Cirrus owner have in common? Well, they all fly Hartzell propellers, and that means they are built on honor. Since 1917, Hartzell has a database of over 4,000 engine and prop combinations, and they're on the cutting edge of propeller technology, taking them into the next 100 years. Thanks, Hartzell, for making flying safer and better. Larry?
Okay, let's go downstairs to the video truck. We'll be right back.
We're almost down to the video truck. Here we go. Canada.org. Rhino Demo's been called up there and given half the field. I guess that means about ready to take off. And until we get ready to introduce the narrator for the BFA 106 Super Hornet demo team, let me take you back to the early 1970s. And that was a time when the United States Air Force was looking for a new lightweight fighter. There were a couple of different competitors for that airplane. One was the Northrop YF-17. The other was the General Dynamics YF-16. Well, the YF-16 won it. It became the F-16 Fighting Falcon. And the YF-17, well, they figured that would either go to a scrap heap or it would end up being in the back corner of some obscure aviation museum. But the Navy needed a new airplane to replace their aging F-4 Phantom IIs. And the one thing the YF-17 had that the YF-16 didn't have was two engines. That became important. So the folks at McDonnell Douglas, now Boeing, and Northrop got together, and it became the FA-18 Hornet. Later on came the Hornet's new sting and the Super Hornet. Larry, we've got some folks to introduce now. Would you like me to introduce Matt as we get going here? From VFA 106, the voice of the Super Hornet demo team, please welcome Lieutenant Matt Eglin from the Chicago, Illinois area, and from Aurora, Illinois. I bet you there's some folks here from Aurora. You probably got a hometown crowd here.
Not that I'm aware of, but you never know.
I bet you a lot are down here. Well, it's we've been in communication with Chins, Chris Walker, and Mark Garcia, Hilo, in the Super Hornet, and we're trying to determine if it's ready to go. Has there been a little bit of holdup? But we're not sure, but we're hoping to find out when they're going to launch. They got it? I'll turn it over to you, sir. It's all yours.
All right, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. My name is Lieutenant Matt Eglin, callsign BTM, and on behalf of the United States Navy, we are proud to present the FA-18 Super Hornet flight demonstration. The Boeing-built FA-18 Super Hornet is the Navy's premier frontline tactical aircraft. The aircraft pouring today is the Foxtrot model, the two-seat variant of the Super Hornet. In today's demonstration, Pilot Lieutenant Chris Walker, callsign Chins from Madison, Wisconsin, and Weapons Systems Officer Lieutenant Mark Garcia, callsign Hilo, from Tempe, Arizona, will fly the Super Hornet to the edge of its operating envelope. During the show, the crew will experience nearly 8 times the force of gravity, accelerate to speeds up to 700 miles per hour, and show the maneuvering capability of the aircraft. Many of the maneuvers seen today will demonstrate the aircraft's capabilities being employed by naval aviators, both in training and in combat. On takeoff, watch as Chin selects maximum afterburner, rolls the aircraft 360 degrees with the landing gear and flaps down, immediately followed by a half Cuban ape. Chins, Hilo, you're cleared for takeoff. Chins and Hilo are setting up for the flat pirouette while they will demonstrate the Super Hornet's unique ability to operate at slow speed and high angles of attack. Watch as they execute a maximum performance loop away from the crowd, and even at slow speed, Chins is able to rotate the nose 180 degrees parallel to the ground. Chins and Hilo are now setting up for the minimum radius turn to the tail stand. Chins will select maximum afterburner, set a 90-degree angle of bank, and hold 7.5 Gs for 360 degrees of turn. At the end of the minimum radius turn, watch as Chin sets up a max performance pull into the vertical, followed by a negative 2G pushover to the level flight. Ladies and gentlemen, from the left, the Super Hornet minimum radius turn.
I wish we could listen in to hear what it sounds like inside the cockpit. Hick, hick, hick.
Crew are now setting up for the high-speed pass. During this maneuver, they will approach show center at 200 feet and nearly Mach 1.0, or just over 750 miles per hour. You may notice the white paper coming off the aircraft, indicating that it's close to the speed of sound. Chins and Hilo will be careful not to exceed the speed of sound because the sonic boom could shatter windows in the surrounding area. The ability to ingress at low altitude and high speeds allows the Super Hornet to avoid detection and preserve the element of surprise. Let's see if we can get Hilo on the radar to see how fast they're going.
Hey, Hilo, this is Rob Ryder and Matt Eglin. Can you hear us?
Yeah, I got you, Rob.
All right, you want to call the speeds as you approach from the right?
Paper.
Here we go. Listen up.
I love your hat.
There's 600 knots. 620 knots.
Yeah, baby.
The next maneuver is the vertical pirouette. Approaching show center at 400 miles per hour, Chins and Hilo will put the aircraft in the vertical and roll the canopy towards the crowd. At the top, the aircraft will push the nose below the horizon, then pull the nose back above the horizon before yawing the aircraft without ever taking its canopy off the crowd. This ability to rapidly swap nose to tail position gives Super Hornet a distinct advantage in the air-to-air arena of the dogfight. Chins and Hilo are now setting up for the square loop. As the Super Hornet approaches show center at 350 miles per hour, Chins will rapidly reposition the nose four times, flying a square path through the sky.
Ladies you've seen round loops. You've seen loops with rolls on top. But let's watch now as Chins and Hilo perform the Rhino square. Hanging from the straps and looking at a huge crowd over Lakeland, they got the best view in the world, Matt.
Oh, I don't doubt it. I wish I was up there with them.
pulling back through at about 2,500 feet. Watch him mush the Super Hornet right there. A big hand for the Super Hornet, square loop.
The air crew are now setting up for the inverted Whisper Pass. As Chins and Hilo approach our center at 500 feet, they will reduce the throttles to idle and roll the aircraft inverted. It takes a lot of concentration to fly upside down while hanging from the straps of your harness. Notice how quiet the aircraft will be as it passes in front of you at over 500 miles per hour. Ladies and gentlemen, from the right, the inverted Whisper Pass. Chins and Hilo are setting up for the High Alpha Pass. This maneuver will show you the incredible speed handling characteristics of the Super Hornet in the slow flight regime. Few of the other aircraft in the world would attempt to maneuver at such a slow speed and high angle of attack. However, the Super Hornet's two digital flight control computers allow it to remain completely controllable while flying at less than 120 miles per hour. In some dogfights, the ability to fly slowly is more important than the ability to fly fast, since this allows the Super Hornet to get behind other aircraft and employ weapons.
Let's see if we can go live to the cockpit and see how slow you're going. Hey, Hilo, what's the speed?
Yeah, we're slowing through 120 miles per hour. It's 115 miles per hour.
115.
110 miles per hour.
110! And how many degrees nose up?
We're currently at 25 hours.
That's awesome. You get any slower, you're gonna turn into a bag of hammers.
As they recover from the split S, Chins and Hilo perform a pitch rate demonstration maneuver to showcase the Super Hornet's excellent pitch authority with 90 and 40 degree turn. Ladies and gentlemen, the job of a naval aviator is not complete until his aircraft is back aboard its floating home, and we take great professional pride in our unique ability to land aboard a 100,000-ton U.S. Navy aircraft carrier. It takes an incredible amount of teamwork to launch and recover aircraft from the launch site. And this capability allows the U.S. to project power from the sea, enter anywhere in the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the carrier break. Even though an aircraft carrier is 1,100 feet long, from the air it appears as small as a postage stamp. In order to land in an area one-tenth the amount of normal-sized runway, carrier aviators must touch down between four wires stretched across the deck of the ship. To do this, we use an optical landing system commonly referred to as the meatball. During the final portion of the approach, the air crew and landing signal officers, known as paddles, work together to get the aircraft safely aboard. Let's listen in on final approach.
Rhino 1-1, 3/4 of a mile, call the ball.
Run an MOO, set the 3/4 mile.
Roger, ball.
Ladies and gentlemen, Commander Naval Air Forces now is proud to present the Navy Tailhook Legacy Flight Demonstration. For over 107 years, naval aviation has not only been at the tip of the spear defending the nation, it has also been at the forefront of technological advances which have made our country great. From the courageous pilots who proved that an aircraft could take off and land, from a ship at sea, to the naval air crews who are taking the fight to the enemy today, a long legacy of excellence and perseverance precedes them. What you are about to witness is dedicated to keeping the naval aviation's ties to its proud legacy alive and well. Tailhook Legacy Flight pairs venerable warbirds with our Navy's past with the high-tech weapon system known as the FAA Super Hornets. In its early years, naval air power played second fiddle to the great dreadnought of the high seas, the battleship. Scouting for enemy ships was the limit of the new aircraft's mission. During World War II, at the battles of Coral Sea and Midway, protecting power from aircraft carriers shaped the future of naval combat. Through the hard work and dedication of private individuals and nonprofits, many of those glorious warbirds are still flying today. Pilots and maintainers play a critical role in keeping the history of naval aviation active. During the air show season, several different vintage warbirds participate in the Tailhook Legacy flights. Some are the only flying examples of their type in the world today. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the F4U Corsair approaching in formation with the Hornet. The Corsair flown by Jim Torque Tobel in the lead aircraft. You'll be able to hear the distinct growl of the Corsair's Pratt & Whitney R2800 18-cylinder radial engine, and the power corrections made by the Super Hornet's two General Electric F-14 turbofan engines to maintain position in the formation. If you look out to the left at about a 45-degree angle, you'll see our Legacy Flight aircraft in a very, very tight formation. The F/A-18F Super Hornet is the premier all-weather strike fighter of today. It fills several roles in the carrier air wing and gives the strike group commander the flexibility needed to engage any threat he or she may face. The missions of the Rhino include air superiority, fighter escort, suppression of enemy air defenses, all-weather day and night precision strike, tactical reconnaissance, and aerial refueling. The Rhino exemplifies our military's might and is a key reason that you can sleep soundly, knowing that the U.S. Navy truly owns the night. Its unique ability to take off and land from the carrier with a fearsome variety of weapons and in any conditions is its hallmark. It is expected to remain in service until at least 2035. Overhead, the F4U Corsair, the F/A-18 Super Hornet. Hope you noticed both of the tail hooks on the airplanes were extended during that pass. It's the tail hook that looks like an antenna from the tail, enables it to land on its floating home at sea, an evolution made famous by the blockbuster movie Top Gun. Stand your ground now as the Rhino and his Corsair wingman charge, or rather change your position in the tailhook Legacy Flight head-on pass. The F4U Corsair, the Korean War hero, is proudly flown and maintained by Mr. Jim Torque Tobel of Jackson, Wyoming. This specific Corsair was built in 1945 and flew over 200 combat missions in two different squadrons from two different aircraft carriers during the Korean War. Corsair saw combat in the Pacific and were also used extensively by the Navy and the Marine Corps in the Korean War. And by the time production of the Corsair ended, over 12,500 were built, giving the Corsair the longest production run of any piston engine fighter produced in the United States, racking up an impressive 11-to-1 kill ratio during the World War II, the Corsair was also used as a fighter bomber, a role that it excelled in Korea. Now from behind and overhead, ladies and gentlemen, the opposing pitch out.
Ready, break.
And after the break now, the Corsair will continue its downwind turn and reconfigure for landing. The Super Hornet will reverse while climbing in the vertical to achieve separation for a carrier break and a landing. Hope you folks enjoyed the Tailhook Legacy Flight demonstration today. Thank you for helping us celebrate more than a century of development at U.S. Naval Carrier Operations. For those of you in the crowd who represent America's leadership of tomorrow, we can't wait to have you join the Naval Aviation Team. F4U Corsair and the FA-18 Super Hornet. As they set up for their landing, their final high-speed pass and landing, let's go downstairs to our friend Lunar, L.M. Sawyer by any other name. And I think she has Mr. Jim Pites with her.
Jim's on his way.
Well, I thought Lunar was down there with Jim Pites, but we'll check back with him very shortly.
This is Lunar with Jim Pites has joined me. He was the pilot of the Bonanza that we all saw. Now, a lot of these aircraft are set up to be aerobatic airplanes. However, Jim's is really a passenger aircraft that he figured out how to take upside down. So, Jim, tell me about how you came up with this idea to fly a Bonanza as an aerobatic airplane.
People go right, I go left. For years, I was in an extra flip-flop, and when things get kind of jammed up and a little bit crowded, I tend to go a different direction. I had this aerobatic Bonanza, and I hadn't air showed it. And a good friend, Danny Clisham, that is an air show announcer, well known, and he says, why aren't you campaigning this airplane? Nobody wants to see a Bonanza upside down, right? Well, who else is doing it, was the comment he made. So we put it out, and it's become really popular. Everybody thinks it's really amazing. Just for the record, it won't do that.
Right.
Yeah. But it's fun. I kind of kid people. I don't get a lot of respect as I'm taxiing out or trying to join the rest of the airshow people on a gaggle back to the hangar. They all look at me and try to put me someplace else. But people are really, it's really fun. They don't expect it to do what it does, and I guess that's part of the mystique and part of the fun. There was 177 of them built. Most of them went overseas and out of the country. I think there's around a dozen left in the U.S. right now.
Now, how long have you had this airplane?
About 12 years. So it's been on the air show circuit about 8. So, and it continues to gain popularity.
Well, Jim, we thank you for joining us today. It's been great to see you and great to see the Bonanza fly. Are you flying any more this weekend?
I am, tomorrow.
So look for Jim Pites in his beautiful Bonanza flying on Saturday. Back to the announcers on the stage, Larry and Rob.
Thank you so much, Lunar. Welcome to the first of 4 stops on the inaugural Grunt Style Airshow Majors Tour. The mission of the Airshow Majors is to celebrate aviation, honor the military, and advance the airshow industry. Stop by the Grunt Style Airshow Majors display located across from the Sunset Grill next to the Hangar A to receive an exclusive gift. And be sure to tag your photos on Facebook and Instagram with @airshow.
Are having an entirely too much fun.
Exactly. And Hi-Ho is probably in the back seat there gigging him on, too. I can just see that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the FA-18 Super Hornet. Hope you're having a great time here. I want to remind all of you that the performers, after they do their little drive-by in the convertible, go to the merchandise tent, and they're there after their performance to sign autographs for you. So if you'd like to go over there and do that, I know they would appreciate seeing you, and they'll be ready and more than willing to sign an autograph for you. Who brings you down here?
Well, the folks who bring me down here are Hartzell Propeller Company and Sporty's Pilot Shop. And there's something new that Sporty's has instituted this year, and that's the Sporty's Flight Crew. Check it out. For just under $50 a year, you could get free shipping on most of the items from Sporty's Pilot Shops, and the Takeoff Pro subscription, which in itself is a $60 value, and lots more. It's kind of like Amazon Prime for pilots, only better. Go to sporties.com/flight crew. Thank you, Sporty's. There's also a great article in this current issue of Sport Aviation Magazine on the Hartzell Propeller Company's first 100 years. Ty Windich wrote it, and it chronicles the first century of the most iconic propeller brand in the world, Hartzell Propeller, built on honor. Larry Strain, back to you, the voice of Lucas Oil.
Well, we've got something special for you to watch here as the FA-18 Super Hornet rolls out, so we're going to throw it down to live air show TV, folks, for just a second.
That became important. So the folks at McDonnell Douglas, now Boeing, and Northrop got...
Our 5,500 associates operate at peak performance day in and day out. We have no days off. But from Miami to Chicago, from LaGuardia to Kansas City, we're all focused on one goal: being the best.
We are Republic!